Hello students, welcome to this video. In the last session we are discussed about ER diagram, right? In this video we are going to discuss about ER model. Okay, ER model is based on the concept of database design. Okay, this is the concept of ER model. It is based on the database design. Okay, and this model have lots of entities. Okay, entities means real world objects. Okay, it should have lots of entities with lots of rules and regulations and dependencies. Okay, this is the main concept of ER model, right? So generally we use an ER model to know the concept of database design. So the concept of database design is the ER model. Okay, this model consists of a collection of entities. Okay, collection of entities means real world objects. Okay, where each of these entities will be interconnected with each other with conditions and dependencies. Okay, that is one entity is depend on another. Okay, one entity is dependent on another entity with lots of conditions and dependencies. Okay, it should be interconnected with each other. Okay, entities are interconnected with each other with lots of attributes. Okay, we will discuss about attributes later on. Okay, so can you understand what is ER model? So the next topic is ER modeling basic concepts. Okay, ER modeling basic concepts, right? So the basic concepts of ER model consist of entity or entity type, attributes and relationship. Okay, the three basic concepts of ER modeling. Okay, these are the general concepts which help to create an ER diagram and produce an ER model. Okay, this is the general concepts which helps to create an ER diagram and produce an ER model. So the next point is, with the help of these, any database design can be created and viewed to know the concept in that database design. Can you understand the point now? So the first basic concept is entity or entity type. Okay, entity or entity type. Now what is mean by entity? Okay, an entity can be anything, a real world object or animation which is easily identifiable by anyone, even by a common man. Okay, it is very easily identifiable by anyone. The user can be identified very easily even by a common man. Okay, this is the concept of entity or entity type. For example, in a company's database, employee, HR, manager are considered as entities, where each of these entity will be having their own attributes. Okay, these are entities having their own attributes. Okay, this is the example. Can you see the figure? So the first box, the first rectangular box is an entity. Okay, the entity name is employee. This employee having many attributes like sales manager, works manager, customer care employee, even the security man. Okay, these are the attributes of this entity. Okay, the entity name is employee. Here, this is the similar point. The manager is an entity having more than work. Okay, these kind of works are called attributes, and the manager is the entity. Okay, can you understand the concept now? So, types of entity. We have discussed in the previous session strong entity, weak entity, and entity instance. Okay, these are the types of entity: strong entity, weak entity, and entity instance. Okay, now what is meant by strong entity? A strong entity is the one which does not depend on any other entity on the schema or database, and a strong entity will have a primary key with it. So this is the main concept of strong entity. Strong entity does not depend any other entity. Okay, it is a single one. Okay, it does not depend anything on the database. Okay, and a strong entity will have a primary key with it. It should have a primary key. Primary key means what? Primary key means it should identify a record. Okay, primary key means what? It should identify a record. A record in the form of table. Okay, a table having rows and columns. Okay, these are identified by using this primary key. Okay, can you understand the concept now? It is represented by one rectangle. Okay, strong entity should identify by using one rectangle symbol. Okay, so the next one is weak entity. Okay, weak entity. A weak entity is depend on other entities and it does not have any primary key. Okay, like the strong entity. So the strong entity does not depend anything on the database or schema, but in the weak entity depend another entity. Okay, in the weak entity is dependent on other entities and it does not have any primary key like the strong entity. Okay, it is represented by double rectangle. So the strong entity is represented by using a single rectangle, but the weak entity is represented by using the double rectangle. Okay, this is the difference. Here we can have one example for weak entity. So here mark as an entity. Okay, it is the main entity and it is the strong entity too. Here we have three attributes. Okay, we have three attributes like exam, subject, pass or fail. Okay, these three attributes are dependent on this main entity. Okay, this is the example of weak entity, because weak entity is dependent on some attributes. Okay, dependent on each other. Okay, this is the example of weak entity. The next one is entity instance. Okay, instance means what? Instances are the values for the entity. If we consider animals as the entity, their instances will be dog, cat, cow, etc. Okay, what is mean by instance? We can give the values to the entity is called instance. Okay, the values to be given to the entity is called the value is an instance of that entity. Okay, for example, if we consider the animals means their instances will be dog, cat, cow, crow, etc. Like, so an entity instance denotes the category values for the given entity. So here we can the table. So these are entity and this is instances. Human as an entity means male, female or transgender is the instances of this human entity. Animal as an entity means dog, cats, lion is then instances of this entity, because these are the values of this entity. So the job as an entity means, job as an entity means engineer, doctor, lawyer. These are the instances of this entity. Okay. Similarly, actors and electronics. Okay. So the next topic is attributes. Okay. What is meant by attributes? An attribute is the information about that entity. Okay. An attribute is the information about that particular entity, and it will describe, quantify, qualify, classify and specify an entity. Okay. This gives the description of entity. Okay. This is the main concept of this chapter. An attribute will always have a single value. That value can be a number or character or string. Okay. An attribute will always have a single value or multi-value, but definitely it should have one value. Okay. At least a single value. In the user provided value, it may be either number, character, string or literal. Okay. This is the concept of attribute. Okay. The next topic is types of attributes. So the next topic is types of attributes. Here we have five types of attributes here. Key attribute, simple attributes, composite attributes, single valued attribute, then multi-valued attributes. Okay. First thing is key attribute. What is meant by key attribute? Generally, a key attribute describes a unique characteristic of an entity. Okay, it should describe a unique characteristic of an each entity. Okay, this is the concept of key attribute. So, the second one is simple attribute. Okay, here we have one entity name as an attribute because of this symbol. Okay, rounded ellipse shape. Okay, this is the attribute, symbol of this attribute. So this attribute have two another attributes. Okay, this is the simple attribute example. One entity having only one attribute and another one attribute having only two attributes. Okay, here this attributes are not interconnected with this entity. This attribute is only interconnected with this entity. Okay, can you understand the difference? This and this is not interconnected. This attribute is interconnected with this employee entity. Okay, can you understand the concept now? So next one is composite attributes. The composite attributes can be subdivided into simple attributes without change in the meaning of that attribute. Okay, it is having subdivision of simple attributes without change in the meaning of that attribute. For example, in the above diagram, the employee is the entity with the composite attribute name, which are subdivided into two simple attributes, first and last name. So consider with this example as a composite attribute means we should have only one entity, okay, only one entity having only one attribute, but this attribute having two attributes. Okay, this is the composition of this attribute functioning. Okay, can you understand the concept now? It is subdivided into two simple attributes. Okay, without any change in the meaning of that attribute. Okay, can you understand the concept now? So the next one is single valued attributes. Okay, it should have single value. A single value attribute contains only one value for the attribute, and they don't have multiple number of values. Okay, only one attribute having only one entity don't have multiple number of values. For example, age, it is a single value for a person, as we cannot give n number of ages for a single person. Therefore, it is a single valued attribute. Can you understand the concept now? Age is a single attribute, means we can have only one value with it. Okay, we cannot assign n number of ages to a single person. Okay, this is the concept of single valued attributes. Only one attribute it should be have. Here, this, see the example, age as an attribute, value as in 3, roll number as an attribute, value as in 85. Okay, here this is the diagrammatic representation of single valued attribute. Here, person is an entity, date of birth is an attribute. This is the simple diagrammatic representation of single valued attributes. Okay, the next one is multi-valued attribute. It is quietly opposite to this single value attributes. A multi-value attributes has more than one value for that particular attribute. Here, for example, degree. A person can hold n number of degrees, so it is a multi-valued attribute. Okay, if a single person have more than one degree, okay, it is the perfect example for multi-valued attributes. Here, see the example, a person having more than one bank account, a person having more than one degrees. Okay, these are the attributes and these are the values. Okay, these are the attributes and attributes, this is values for each other. So the next concept is relationship types. Okay, relationship types. In ER model, relationship exists between two entities. Okay, three types of relationships are available, and the entity relationship diagram is based on the three types listed below. Okay, so the relationship type having three types: one to one relationship, one to many relationship, and the next one is many to many relationship. Okay, it should have three relationship types. Okay, first of all, we see one to one relationship. These three things are very, very simple and important too. Okay, here student and exam number. So here Tamil Chelvi is an entity having only one entity. Okay, one entity having another one entity. Okay, only one entity is possible. Okay, only one entity is possible. Jayapandian having only one exam number, and Sarojini having only one exam number. This is the one to one relationship. Okay, each entity having another one entity. This is thus the concept of one-to-one relationship. So the next one is one-to-many relationship. One-to-many relationship means here only one attribute, only one entity having more than one attribute values. Okay, here computer having Gajalakshmi and Bindu. So the next department, the Tamil department having Ramesh and another one student name. Okay, here max department having Bindu and Radha student. Okay, Radha staff. So this is the simple diagrammatic representation of one to many relationship. Can you understand the concept now? What is mean by one to one and what is mean by one to many relationship? Next one is many to many. Here we have attribute having more than one combinations. Okay, only one attribute having more than one entity. So this is the diagrammatic representation of many to many relationship. Very very simple concept, but very important. Okay, these are the relationship types. So the next concept is relationship instance. Okay, relationship instance. Each instance of the relationship between members of these entity types is called a relationship instance. For example, if a person having a vehicle, okay, a person having a vehicle, definitely we drives the vehicle. Here the driving is the instance for these two relationship. Okay, can you understand the concept now? This is the relationship instance. Okay, so the next topic is degree of a relationship. Degree of a relationship. Okay, the number of entity types involved is known as degree of relationship. Okay, the number of entity types involved is known as degree of relationship. 1 unary, 2 binary, and 3 as ternary operators. These are the examples of degree of a relationship. Okay, unary operator having only one, but binary operators having two numbers, that is 0 and 1. Ternary operator is also having three values. Okay, so here we have another three examples to the concept of cardinality. The first one is, okay, the first one is one unary. Okay, if a person, here we consider the same example. If a person having vehicle means definitely he drives, he or she drive. So this is the cardinality of this concept. Here next one is customer and order. Customer place an order means the respective product will reach that particular customer. So this is the cardinality of this concept. So the next one is student and course. Student having particular course means, first of all, he or she register their name with their enrollment number. So this is the cardinality of this concept. So these are the concepts of relationship types and relationship instance, degree of a relationship. Finally, the concept is cardinality. So, can you understand the concept now? Thank you for watching this video, students. I hope all of you understand that.